Good afternoon again, everybody, and a very warm welcome back to the channel. We're in Alaska today with the Orbex Mesh and the Aerosoft Twin Otter. And in addition to all of that, we've got some fantastic freeware as well. A little bit of a group flight. So if you have got the scenery, feel free to join us. We're on the JoinFS network and their Digital Theme Park server. Bill, hello. Just now being introduced to the Twin Otter, thinking about purchasing it. I love it. It's fantastic. Good fun, good little add-on. You can explore loads of remote parts of the world like this fantastic Kodiak Island. Bacazzato, good afternoon as well. Hope you're well. It's myself and Jay at the moment. Nighthawk is at an airfield nearby. PAKH, I think, is the ICAO code. And we're floating along by Dead Man's Bay. Our route today is a bit of an odd one. I can't really show you it particularly well. Because it doesn't recognise all of the airports and things like that. But there we are at the moment in Dead Man's Bay. Been floating around for the last 10-20 minutes. So, hence the weird drawing and things there. We're going to head south down the bay, climbing up. We're going to go over this little bit of terrain here. Through the middle, over the lake, up to Olga Bay Seaplane Base as well. We're going to do a little bit of a landing there. That's Akiok. P-A-K-H. So if you are struggling to find us, then you can start from here. P-A-K-H. And then we're going to continue through Kodiak Island, past Fraser Lake, Carlock River, Carlock Lake Seaplane Base, over Larsen Bay. Like so, stopping off at a couple of the seaplane bases and other bases along the way. So we're going to weave around all the terrain, as you can see here, around Uganik Bay, northeast arm of Uganik Bay as well, around the island into San Juan, Uganik's seaplane base. And then we're going to break off up towards Afognak Island, because we want to head up to here. There is a little waterfall bay, it's called, or Waterfall Lake Bay. There's a seaplane base, but also a gravel or dirt strip here too. So we're going to be exploring the island. You can see the sim has struggled with the plotting of the routes and things, and even Valanta doesn't really, it's not too happy with it. Once we've navigated all of these anyway, about five airfields or so, we're going to head into Kodiak Municipal Airport. And throughout this we've got loads of freeware scenery. We've got the We Love VFR Area 2 installed, and in addition to that we've got the Orbex Alaska Mesh working in conjunction with it, and this Kodiak Island Mega Pack too, with a couple of dependencies as well. Ian, good day to you. Fenian, welcome. Loving the look of the Twin Otter. Our liveries, by the way, for the Twin Otter, painted by Tapsy. You can download them via our website, britishavgeek.com/liveries, if you do want to get your hands on these. Got loads of liveries available at the moment. Min in Vietnam, good evening to you. Leo, good afternoon. And Mount, hello. Beside the amazing Aerosoft CRJ, what other aircrafts are worth the money? Would be good if it's a complete aircraft. Good question. So I love the Twin Otter. It's not complete in the sense that it's properly in depth, but it's really good fun. I'm killing the engines. Let's get these back up here. So I've had the props in feather mode for a little while. Ian's just loading in. Fantastic. And the kid, welcome. So this is the amphibious variant. You need to steer on the ground using differential thrust and things like that. But we've got wheels up for water, blue. We can dim the lights, bright, make them brighter, down for land. Do not land on water until gear is fully retracted, because it will snap off. Jay says up here will follow me. Fantastic. I don't know where I'm going. Jay, by the way, created this route. What's the surface altitude that you flew at, Jay? Out of curiosity. We want flaps 10. And up here. Let's That's all looking good. And we can turn the landing lights and things on as well. Like so. Theo, yes, some seaplane action. I've not actually set any custom views, so I might use the opportunity as we're bobbling along to set a couple. And of course, in the Twin Otter, these work. So we can open those up if we want to. And we can open the door there as well. Not that we necessarily would in this instance. $3,500, fantastic. I guess we don't really spend too long at that altitude either. If you're new to the channel, do hit subscribe down below. Ah, turbo sticks loaded in, fantastic. So, what have we got here? We don't really know where we're going for a lot of these. Even little nav map doesn't have a lot of these seaplane bases and things added in. But the first stop is Olga Bay. It's also really fun to use the US sectional option on Volanta. Okay, let me try and find that. Here we go, so I can show you guys as I try and sort of locate this. Oh, there we go, look at that. That's how we're going to navigate today, folks. As it loads in, so out of here, over this little terrain, south of Greyback Mountain, numerous cabins. And then Olga Bay seaplane base just there. That's where we're heading to first. And then we're going to head up towards Carlock Lake. I think, are we doing Carlock Lake? I can't remember. San Juan up here. That's quite cool. I like that a lot. Okay, there we go. We can leave that on. I feel like I should follow Jay. He knows where he's going. I haven't got the foggiest of ideas. Marcos, welcome on board. Thanks for hitting subscribe. Here we go. So, differential throttle. So I'm using the left prop to steer us left. And I'm trying to capture that as well, just so we roll out facing Jay. Or into the lake as well. And we've got all the lights on, ready to go now. As you can see here, this little bit of differential on the throttle has given us enough to steer off course slightly, which we don't want. So we need to put in a little bit of right prop and get us back. Jay's going, good stuff. That's bizarre. And it's successfully connected. Oh, Jay's off, here we go. Okay, so we've got everything prepped. I'm going to set a little bit of power. And let's go to 50. There we go, let's rock and roll, bobbing along. We've got the landing rate manager working today as well. And away we go. Look at this, beautiful scenery. Trim for 75 on the prop RPM, and we want about 40 for climb out. And we're going to chase J along the way. If Finland, hello to you, welcome. Simcrash, Ian, no problem at all. You can join us from that first seaplane base at Olga Bay, is it? As we make our way up through this little bit of terrain here. Most of this is going to be manually flown because I was hoping to have some navigational stuff loaded in, but it's not really going to work for us, I don't think, today. But that's fine. We're up. First time flying the amphibious Aerosoft Twin Otter variant as well. Chris, good morning slash afternoon. Hello, welcome. Here we are. Look at this. First time flying around Kodiak Island, Alaska. Now, of course, the handling characteristics of this is going to be quite a bit different, actually, I think. There's Jay, jolly good. We can still see him. And Twin VM 2000, welcome. So I want a little bit of autopilot, heading mode. That'll do us for now. That's autopilot. Hello, yes. Head to our Discord server. If you've got a little nav map, it'll work a bit better for you. But yes, inside there in the live streams tab is our routing for today. It's been a little while since we used the Twin Otter, the first time certainly using this particular one, so nice to see how it all works. Halfway already to the first stop, Olga Bay. I'm not entirely sure what it's like landing these. Going to be random sounds and chimes. Very cool, look at that. Now, with live weather on at the moment, you'd get all of the lakes covered in snow, which is quite exciting as well. Adds a little bit more of a dynamic to it. But of course, we want to see everything in all its glory. Olga Bay is that there. And we're actually using Floyd's Epic Clouds today. Jay, I'm assuming that we're going to land at Olga Bay briefly. Oh, wrong way. That doesn't sound very good. Back us also. We're heading to Olga Bay Seaplane Base. Change the prop pitch for a descent now. If you've got a little nav map, you should be able to see us down there. But we're heading into this little section here, and there's a river that goes up and through. Oh, I can see another pilot down there. Ah, in fact, that is Olga Bay. There we are with the river. That's going to take us through once we've landed there. Is there a is it just a seaplane base here, Jay, or is it a like a bit of a gravel strip as well? Makasato, you could join in the DC-6 if you wish. You might struggle with the floating element though. There's Olga Bay. A little ship there as well. And we're following Jay, basically. Sully remastered Leo, yes. Bit of a difference from our usual type of flying, of course. But it's nice to appreciate the simulator with all it's got. These sort of add-ons. Ronnie, hello to you, welcome. Are we flying the updated Twotter? We are indeed. Oh, Jay's down in the water. Let's come out here. And we're gonna sweep round. Oh, I'm too far. I'm too fast for this. The Gracken Verb, welcome. Here we go. Gonna hold off the water here. Yeah. Not yet. Not yet. There we go. Oh, I'll take that for a water landing. We're logging this on Osprey Regional, of course. Osprey Airways. Even the passengers are clapping. Olga Bay, tiny. We've got somebody, L.I. and Bakasato as well in the DC-6 somewhere above. Let's see if we can spot him. Might change some of these clouds as well. There's the DC-6 in all its glory. We've got a Cessna as well. Oh, good to see that they can float. Fantastic. Okay, next stop. I think let's have a little scroll through this. We might be doing a little touch and go at Larsen Bay, a little gravel strip. Oh dear, here comes Bakasato in the DC-6. Oh dear. Fantastic add-on for MSFS. Absolute joy to fly. Leo's got the Cessna with the floats on. In fact, I think I can change that on JoinFS. So let's have a little look. Aircraft. Substitute. There we go. Got you with the floaters on now. There he is. Let's catch Jay up. Wesley, good afternoon. Welcome. Wesley, every little helps, eh? David, hello to you. Welcome. Hope you're well. There's our 50. Jurassic, good afternoon. And away we go. He says gently, but the sim really doesn't like water, does it? Bakazata's having a blast. Let's get some of these flaps in as well, as we then climb out. What we got here? Proper RPM. Perfect. Das Autopilot, we are on the JoinFS network, joinfs.net, and their Digital Theme Park server. Basically, it's like VATSIM, but without ATC. And round we go. We're just going to sweep back on upon ourselves. And up we go. There's someone else taking off over there. Little Cessna. You can see somebody there. And we'll turn left. We're going over Olga Bay now. Little fly past, if you will. And what do we want here? 345 mag. About here. Like so. Oh yeah, Jurassic. It's looking pretty good, isn't it? Alaska. I keep meaning to do some DC-6 ops around Alaska as well, of course, but not been able to get round to it just yet. Ah, oh, there is a grass strip, gravel strip there. We could have done that one. Don't bother. As a salt, welcome. Edahort's just there, we can see his lights. I'm not faffing around too much with landing lights and things today, because it's we'll leave them on. It's not like we're paying for the bulbs. So there we are, look at that. Wonderful wing views. And Zeb Zebs, welcome. How are you doing? There's going to be a lot of unknown flight reports today for Osprey Airways. 3-2 coming up. Akizato's headed our way as well. Oh, I can see you actually there in the DC-6. Zeb, doing really well, thank you. Thanks for asking. Hope you're enjoying it today. David's asking when for Xbox. Good question. I'm not sure, actually, to be honest. I don't know if it'll be coming out soon or... Akizato's back there somewhere in the DC-6. Hazard, I've never been to Hong Kong, no. Turbulent air. I have no idea where Gatorhawk is going. He's over here somewhere. Right, our next stop is... Larsen Bay, I should say. Papa Alpha Lima Bravo. There's a seaplane area and also a little grass strip thing. Yeah, I was just about to get run over by a DC-6. Fantastic. Here he comes. There's Bakazato sweeping in. Hey, such a good aeroplane that. Oh, that might be Bakazato crashing. Yep. Oh, maybe not. He's just buzzing the valley down below. And we got Gatorhawk, or Jay, over here somewhere, level with us, altitude-wise, 3,500 feet. Ah, there he is, I can see him there. Perfect. There's Bakazato, flying the valley. Ah, there he is, got him. Trying to think where he was visually. He's taking the scenic route, of course. It's because I'm reading JoinFS, not JoinFS, little nav map. It keeps popping up as Gatorhawk rather than Jay. Can't see no DC-6 lurking just yet. feeling is a lot closer than I realise. There he is. Oh, fantastic. So, let's swing a right. Oh, where'd it go? Ah, there he is. I'll spot him out the window here. Look at that. He's getting all of us. He's off to get Jay now. So what we'll do at Larson is we'll commit to, I think it's inside that area here actually. Yeah, there's the river. I can see the river on the map. So just at the bottom of this hill here, where this little bit of land juts out, that's Larson Bay. And the airfield, you've got a bit of a seaplane area, but also a gravel strip, I think, potentially, just on the land there, which is what we're going to be targeting. Terrain-wise, I think we're good for 2,500 now. As a no, I haven't actually. Apex 109, welcome on board. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. A bit different from the airliner stuff that we usually do, of course. That's looking pretty good, isn't it? I reckon we go down to 1.5. There's Bakazato again. I think that's the fastest DC-6 I've ever seen. And Lion is over there somewhere. Let's see if we can spot him in one of these. Where's my wing views? So he should be exactly on the wing. In the valley there somewhere. Jay had the DC-6 display as an A380, fantastic. Rather ominous that coming towards you then. I think we can see Larson Bay. Yes, there's the runway. Perfect. Now we've got runway 04 here. What we're going to do is we're going to come out over the water. We're going to sweep round into 04. And we're going to have to stop before we hit the water, of course. But we shall see what happens. Look at that. Spectacular. Very nice indeed. Don't forget to like today's stream as well, of course, if you are enjoying it. And if you do want to join us, then you've got a little bit of time. We're going to be heading round Kodiak Island. At Larson's Bay in the water, can't get my PC6 to stop moving. You know what? I found the same thing with this. Once the props, if the props weren't feathered, then I'd just start moving around, skating around left and right all the time. Found it quite difficult to manage, actually, as well, I have to say. Let's take the autopilot off. We want gear down. There they go, there's the animation for it.
Brilliant.
Love it. Get a bit of power in here as well. Lost sight of the runway. It was here somewhere though, wasn't it? So we need to sweep out and round. Peter, hello, welcome. It's looking very nice, nice scenery. Thank you, yes. Alaska's Orbex mesh, but also quite a bit of freeware added on top as well. God Arise, welcome. Thanks for subscribing. Aaron, the sounds, yeah, they've been worked on a lot actually by the Aerosoft team, it has to be said. To follow this coastline here because the runway is going to pop up on us any second. So go flaps 20 now. Oxygen 795, welcome. Is that the runway? Yes, it is. Was that the road? Well, that's a road. I can see somebody there in the amphibious Twin Otter, so I'm going to use them as a reference. Ah, there's the runway, got it. Yes, sweeping over the hills. There's the lights. Oh, back at Zato. Oh. I think we're going to hit each other here, aren't we? This is chaos. Oh, hello. And weird ghost control issues there. Oh, we're going through, everybody. Oh. Mikhail, hello, welcome. So this is Larson Bay, 330 foot per minute. Ah, damn it. I'm gonna have to work hard to get those stats fixed. Ian's on the ground, good stuff. There's the sort of seaplane type base area. Zebs. Okay, let's let's reverse back out of here. Oh. Oh God. Oh dear. Oh Christ. It doesn't like that at all, does it? Getting some weird control issues at the moment. Okay, let's go back to the start of the runway then. Peter, worse than Mykonos. We've got another seaplane base to go to next. We're going to be heading out for over Carlson Point, round the bay, across into... Where have we got here? East Armuganik. Sally Island, there we go. And Port O'Brien. Seaplane base there. Might as well make use of this extra little bit of tarmac to assist. That's almost like a little downhill kick as well for us. That's going to be helpful. He says as my steering is now locked. Fantastic. Straight out over the water for this departure. I want to make sure we've got flaps about 20, I think, for this one. It is quite a short field. Yes, done. Okay. Reset that. Props are full. On the brakes. Part brake off. There's 30. There's 50. And away we go. We can get the gear up. Somebody on the water down there, Ryan, I think that is. And there goes Bacchisato taking off. Okay, out we go. A little bit more power, we want 40 torque. We can bring these flaps back to zero now as well. It says Carlson Point dead ahead. I think we could probably fly about this altitude as well. Where's my little heading bug? There it is. So we want to go due... Was it 313 degrees now, actually? So... Call it 320. There we are. Out over the water. We're going to stick to the water with this. Oh, Peter, you've still got time. It's just a free-for-all today, just us mucking about, having a good laugh. Yeah, back as answer, that would be quite cool, wouldn't it, if we did have that feature. We're going to be heading around that little point over here. And then going off into the valley behind this this hill. So we're going to be doing a bit of weaving. Stick to 1,000 feet. Ethan's Aviation, hello, welcome, hope you're well. Let's go out to 340 now. It'll probably go even further than that now. We head due north. 360. We'll do 010 actually. Round we go. Magazzardo's chasing in the DC-6. There he is. Oh dear. George Mack, welcome on board. Thanks for subscribing. All the links to all the scenery, by the way, today are in the description for today's live stream. So if you haven't already got the Aerosoft Twin Otter, or you want to explore places like this, Alaska, then all you've got to do is have a little look there. Or similarly, inside our Discord server as well, I've put all of the details in there as well. 040. Though it is going to be more like 06 by the time we roll out. Ah, we're good, we're hugging it. There we go, keep going. It's going to be 083. Proper. Which is about there. Oh, we've got our first jet. I wondered when that would turn up. Apparently that's Lion. I do want to do another group flight actually in the Twin Otter at some point soon. The Just Flight Hawk in the near future. Zeb, so we're going to get the DC's Designs Concorde, hopefully, yeah. Oh, off he goes. It's gone vertical. And he's out of view. Crikey. Definitely in the jet then, not Cessna. Oh, there goes Bacchazzato. Just a plane. Yeah, when the DC Designs Concorde comes out, I think what I'm going to do is just dive straight into a live stream as we try and master it across the pond, perhaps. We'll do Heathrow to JFK or something. And I'll see if I can master it from start to finish. And go supersonic. Let's have a little check on progress here. We've got a turn down here now. So we'll go 015. Zach, welcome. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. Welcome on board to you. Check out to Heathrow via Anchorage for a double oceanic. That's huge though, isn't it? It's a massive, how long is that gonna be actually for a flight time? I'm not entirely sure. Poseidon, hello. The next airport is a seaplane base, probably in about 10 minutes or so. It's San Juan seaplane base. Just alongside Sally Island. We're going to be crossing over... Oh, have I overcooked this? Now, we need to get to the other side of this hill, and I'm hoping the valley stays low. Otherwise, my scenic 1,000 foot has backfired. Tritz, just watched the new video about our new pushback toolbar. Toolbar pushback update. Huge, isn't it, right? It's fantastic work that they've done. Ambitious pilots team. I think we're going to have to climb. Let's get up. Height is safety. We supposedly should be going over here now, but we're not. There is a lake the other side, so it shouldn't should be too steep. We just need to get around this little ridge. We'll follow the terrain round. It should go straight into another lake. So 1,000 foot should be fine. Danny Brown, hello to you. Jar as well, hello, welcome. Hopefully the Nightbot is paying attention. That river down there. There we go, fantastic. There's our yoke as well. We're going to get a lot of these terrain warnings today, I think. It's definitely a dip past this hill, so that's going to be fine, I think. We'll monitor that. Gonna get quite tight. Zeb's lake is all ice. Yeah, so if you turn off live weather, you'll get all the ice clear basically. Looks very good though with all the ice on, doesn't it? It has to be said. What do we want here? 332. Oops, wrong way. Around we go. There's the lake that we wanted to go to. Gatorhawk, well, Jay has climbed up over the ridge. He's taken the sensible option. We have not. The rest is water-based throughout all of this, actually, so we can drop back down to about 1,000. We'll just do a very slow descent. Yeah, Dr. Paul, that doesn't sound fun. It doesn't, does it? 15 hours in the Concorde. No thanks. How's my fuel doing? Okay, we might have to refuel at the next bit. I say refuel, what I'm going to do is just drag the slider across. There's Bakazato. Wow, look at that. Trying to remember how to turn off the GPWS now. Three, three, two. Let's set that. So we're going up through the lake. It would be fun. Very fun to watch the DC-6 land on that, yes. There is a GPWS button. I feel like it's going to be in here. I feel like it's going to be in here somewhere. Where else could it be? I can't remember. I know it's none of those. Oh, there we go. It's literally in front of me the entire time. GPWS inhibit, job done. West Point Village seaplane base is through here somewhere. It's inside this. In fact, it's in this little section here. Maybe we can overfly, have a little look. These guys are doing great to stay on the tail. Especially. That does not look fun in the DC-6, does it? Clinging on for dear life. There's one of the little seaplane bases you can land at. Little ship there as well. So that juts out. So yeah, there we go. There's the pontoons, actually, for the seaplane base. Very cool. And there's an additional pontoon there as well. There's a few. There we go. There's one there, right in the middle as well. That's quite cool. We want to go 091 degrees now. Round we go, big turn. Couple of ships in the lake. Yeah, yeah, the boat's add-on, definitely a must. Absolutely. I'll try and get that GoPro type view on the dash. Not doing a great job at that though. There we go. Having said that, we need to come right more. I'm going to call that 010, or 100 degrees, I think. I want to go down to the centre of that lake, and then we've got Sally Island, and just where that ship is to the other side, we've got San Juan Seaplane Base as well to head into. So let's go down to 500. Alt. Down. It's much better without the terrain every 2 seconds. Oh, that looks good. Look at that. Stick that in black and white. That'd look fantastic. We're going to go round Sally Island. Go full prop. Right, so that's back to 100% RPM. That is cool, look at that. Blood Money, welcome aboard. Thanks for subscribing, welcome to the channel. I'm going to try and get around here for a screenshot of the two of us flying in formation. Now would you look at that. Mackie Simulations, hello, welcome. Have to jump back in here now because we're very quickly going to be flying this, so let's get round the corner. David, not sure when it's going to be released for Xbox, hopefully soon. Go through this little ridge over the ship. And then we've got San Juan right ahead of us. That's fantastic. There we go. So we've got the pontoons here. Gonna have to very quickly take over here because you find that the you come out of reverse prop. And yeah, you guys can see what happens. There's San Juan. Look at that for a little seaplane base. Trits, no. Just whenever I've got time off. Not always on Sundays, sadly. Oh dear. This is a bit of a mess, isn't it? Zeb's spinning around in circles. There goes Bakazato, barely clinging onto control. Actually, that's not even Bakazato. That is somebody in another Twin Otter. Here comes Bakazato. He's going for a full and frank flyby. Right, next stop. We've got to try and get this turned around as well. So use one prop to help turn. That's a bit too quick on the turn. There we go. Good grief. Right, let's go. That's about 50. Aiming for those nav lights. Where we go? Wow, Bob. About to start a flight from San Diego to San Francisco. Very nice little route in the TBM. Fantastic. Okay, we're gonna have to climb to about 3,000 now. Back out over the lake where we came. I need that heading bug round here to assist me as well. There we go. I'll do 800 foot per minute. Fleet of pilots behind us. We're going to go around Uganik Island as well now, Raspberry Island. Van Island. Okay, so the next stop is the Waterfall Lake, which has got a gravel strip. And also a water strip. Now, are we going to hit the terrain here? No, we're fine. We're going to go through this little gap. Perfect. Watch on board. Funnily enough, there are boats available in the sim. Well, sadly, there are boats available in the sim. Not for everybody. Not quite sure why you'd purchase a boat add-on for Microsoft Flight Simulator, though. Mint. Look at that. It's really good. Shauno, I believe that is just about keeping up with us. Flying perfectly in formation. We're going to be following the coastline of the lake coming up as well, or the sort of the other side of the lake. Wrong button. There we go. So we're going to be going up there. Looping round and then heading off into that mountainous region over there slightly. We set that nearer to 40. Prop RPM is 75 on both. Fuel's looking fine. Flying boats. Yeah, that would be quite interesting, wouldn't it? What's that? 300 degrees to get to the edge of that coast. Let's make the turn. Isn't there actual boat simulators for sailing boats, though? Or am I missing the point entirely? Ah, perfect. 3,000. Happy days. And Island Control, good afternoon. Hope you're well. Got quite the gaggle on us now, look at that. That DC-6. Brilliant. All the screenshots today will go on to Valanta, of course, as well. And we'll have a look on Valanta with the US sectional map when we do arrive in our final destination, so you guys can see what our routing looked like today. In fact, let's look now, see what we've our progress has been like so far. So we departed Dead Man's Bay, which is here. Bit of a bump. It's shown landing ratings on Valanta, even though it hasn't actually happened. We went to Olga then, bobbed around a lot on the water, and then we've climbed up round the valleys over the river to Larson's Bay. We've just done this around Uyuk, South Arm, East Arm, Ooganik Bay. We've done Sally Island, which is just there, and now we're heading out over the water to where is it? Here, basically. There we go, that cabin is exactly where we're going next, via the scenic route. Flying the flag for BMDG. We've got liveries for the ski variant of the Twin Otter, and also the amphibious and the Tundra Wheels Packs version, which you can see just behind us here, for the Osprey regional arm of Osprey Airways. All our liveries are free to download, of course, as well, so do have a little look. Zebs, take care. I think we need to turn. Yes, we do. We need to go off that way. Round we go. What are we going to go here? 0. I'm going to say 030. 035. Round it up. There we go. We'll see how that looks when we roll wings level. Perhaps not. 050. Ryan's buzzing around up here somewhere in a King Air. And we're going to be heading where this little island juts out here. We're going to follow the furthest part of the lake round to pretty much as far as we can see just here as it bends off left and disappears. That's little Raspberry Island. Apparently there's a boat there, a multiplayer ship apparently. And then we're going to head north over all the terrain, Ban Island, and then in towards Waterfall Lake, which is quite cool actually. It's a very nice scenic part of Alaska to go and fly around. 06. Mimi, welcome on board. Hello to you. Thanks for subscribing. The passengers getting that little ominous look of the DC-6 popping into view over there. And Peter, yeah, we got Volanta Premium. Really good, actually, Volanta Premium. I like it a lot, and it records your state. So if you get a crash to desktop for whatever reason, you can reload the flight using the state saving feature that they've got. Jurassic, yeah, so you know what, I'd love to see the old sort of Microsoft Combat Flight Simulator get reinvented. That'd look quite cool, wouldn't it? Let's see, 080 now, I think. It'll take us towards the edge of the coastline as it juts around. Probably the strangest route that I've done on the sim so far, I think. For those of you who remember the Twin Otter release, a lot of people were quite critical of the sounds. If you were one of those people, what do you think of the sounds now, having heard them today? Do you think they're a lot better? Do you think they're improved? Do you think they're kind of the same level? I think it's great. The Alaska Marine Highway down below, apparently, according to little nav maps, all the ships heading around Alaska use this particular route. Oh, Jurassic, now that's a question. I think it was the highest altitude possible in the sim, about 100,000 feet. To be honest, I'm surprised somebody hasn't created a spacecraft already. Peter, no, so good question. Let's load it up quickly if you are just tuning in wondering the same thing. All you've got to do is click map settings, go down to the bottom and turn on US sectional map. You can have satellite mode as well, so it looks like this. That's actually quite nice, isn't it? Might leave that on. We're going to go for US sectional anyway for now. If you've not done so already as well, check out the survey that I've got in the community tab, the post section on the channel too. Basically, I'm trying to create merchandise that you guys want to have, basically. So all of your feedback is being read and is welcomed. I've only had 3 responses so far to the membership, merchandise survey. Everybody's opinion is welcome. Peter, no problem at all. Let's see, can we see our comrade? There he there he is, just about to see him through the window. Peekaboo. Fantastic. Oh, there he goes. Shy. Look at that. Spectacular. So, Little Raspberry Island is this little bit here. And we need to head the other side of this peak, actually, over into that terrain. I'm hoping our ceiling is good enough. We'll start the turn now. We'll do 030. Jesse, what's Elite Dangerous like? I've never played it. Obviously, I've seen videos of it from Obsidian Ant, but beyond that, I don't really know too much about it. Random little beach down there. I'm hoping we're not going to come into any problems. 688 meters in feet is 2,257 feet, so that's fine. That means we're going to be flying over a peak, a couple of hundred feet separation, and then we're in the clear up towards Ban Island. Okay, that's good. That's going to be one of these peaks up here then, isn't it? We shall head due north for a little bit. Got no other peaks that we're going to contend with. 688, 615. So we've got Afnagap Mountain, which is this one here that's right in front of us. A couple of hundred feet below on the peak, but we're going to be slightly to the right of that. And then we've got Hatchery Peak, 615 metres, which is that little mountain there. Strangely enough, all the other mountains that we can see in the distance, which look higher, aren't on little nav map. So this particular one, we've got two options. We've got the water strip and we've got the gravel strip. So I'm gonna try and land on the gravel strip. It's quite narrow, quite short. Trees at the end of it as well, I think, from memory. Jurassic, yeah, sounds a bit boring then. We're going to head up to Ban Island. Let's see. We need to go. About here, 349. I'm not certain we're going to pass these peaks, to be honest. I think that might be Ban Island. I'm not sure if that might be Ban Island there, actually. That little bit there, jutting out into the distance here. That might be Ban Island. Then we're going to go off further into the mountains. But I've got no information about peaks, terrain, height whatsoever here. Beyond what we've already found. The cloud peak to the left of us, 721 metres. And that's Afnagak Mountain that we're just passing at the moment. Jay, thanks for the super chat. No worries at all. Thanks for creating such a wonderful route as well. I'm glad you've been able to join us for some of it at least. Thanks for your super chat. Really appreciate your generosity there, supporting the stream as well. Once YouTube catches up, of course. Takes a while, doesn't it?
I'm going to have to drop off for prior engagement. Had a blast as always. Thank you.
There we are. Thanks, Jay. And welcome aboard Full English as well for hitting subscribe. Welcome to the channel. Now this one's going to be a difficult one into this lake because we're going to have to lose altitude potentially inside the lake, and it's actually a really small lake as well. We've got all of this terrain to get through. What have we got here? Say about 10 nautical miles to Ban Island, which is this thing in front of us. Just that little bit of a body of water starting to come into view. We're then going off over these peaks here, and inside there is a tiny little lake in the valley. Probably 3,000 feet below us as well, so who knows? We're gonna have to we'll have to assess it when we get overhead, I think. It's appeared on the map now as well. PZO, whatever it is. PZO5 maybe. Oops. DGB is Danger Bay. And I might do a touch and go at that on the way back, I'm not sure actually. Two airfields left. Hello, Cheeky. That's fantastic. Giving us a little wave there. Okay, there's Ban Island. So we want to go 052 mag over towards those peaks. Over and through, in fact. And then in 10 nautical miles, we're overhead the airfield. Let's do 04 for now. Actually, we'll do 05. 052-ish. 050, that should be fine. Right, so looking ahead, we've got that massive peak. Now that's not on my little nav map. But I've got a feeling that actually the bay is in there somewhere. We just can't yet see it. In fact, it could be that. Just coming into view here. I think it is, you know. I think that's Waterfall Bay. But we can't really lose any height until we get past all of this. And then even then, it's going to be gradual bits. It's got to be that. It's got to be that. Still got five others flying along. Great to see. Hope you're enjoying it if you are flying with us. Something a bit different anyway, at least. There goes the peak of that mountain. Yeah, you know what? I am 100% certain that that is Waterfall Bay. So let's risk it. Props back to full, 100%. We'll let them stabilise. We want 10 for the descent as well. Can we just get hit by wake turbulence? I'm not sure if we did or not. Maxato's broke off left. Where's he gone? Look at that. Remarkable. There's the King Air. Rightio. Right, okay, so we're going to overfly the airstrip, actually. It's in there somewhere. So the bay... The actual seaplane base is in this tiny little nook here, and there's a tiny little gravel strip or dirt strip just nestled between the trees. So I want my altitude back. We'll set 1,000 for now. I feel like we've got wake turbulence, I'm not sure why. See the strip? Ideally, we want visual with it, of course, before we commit in. There it is. Wow, look at that. It's going to be good. Nighthawk's still here. Fantastic. Ah, yes, I can see you actually in the background. It's PC6. Can't keep up. Landing it down. Now we've got four green. It's nice to see they lock in quite quick. Look how green this is. Yeah, we've actually got a route for the Maldives, which I'm hoping to do for another group flight soon. In the Twin Otter. So watch this space. And of course that one will actually have everything rendered in properly, so you'll be able to join us probably a bit easier as well. There we go, we're going in here. 500. Now interestingly, I've lost my elevator control. And it's back again. I wonder if FSUIPC 7 is playing up. Or it's the sim. You know, when you turn, you look around, it breaks things. This is visual, entirely visual, so... It's going to come up on us very quickly here. I'm not sure. I'm not convinced I've got the right little bit, actually. No, there it is. 80. We've got full flaps on and gear down. There's the seaplane base just underneath the wiper. Oh. Wow. And at the top of the hill. We're struggling to stop. Brilliant. Of course we are. That was close. That's the one I was most looking forward to. Getting out is going to be a challenge. Oh God, what have I done? We got one coming in. King Air. It's a tight one, isn't it? It's uphill as well, so it gives you a bit of a false sort of reading as well. It's gone for a fly past. I've got to get back up that little hill now as well for the next bit. 1, 2, 3. 3 are flying around, 4 are flying around still. We can get rid of our flaps, but I want to set flaps 30, I think, for this one. Anyone else giving it a go before we zoom off? Oh, Bacchazzato's done the ground. He's gone for a departure. Oh. Yeah, I ran out of the runway basically. There's Bacchazzato stuck. Right, let's see. That's the one I want. We need to get up this hill. Thankfully, this is the go anywhere, do anything aeroplane, so perfect for it. King Air's giving it another go. And there's a Twotter, there's Nighthawk arriving. He's down, look at that, fantastic. Don't worry about me being in the way, just go through me. Nice work, that was much better than my job actually, that. Fantastic. Right, flaps 30 for this one. Let's chase. Gonna hold it on the brakes. Off the brakes. 50%. Come on. Come on, down the hill helps us. I'm almost out of runway. And we're up, almost in the trees. Good grief. Just avoiding the trees, I think. And we'll get that gear up as well. Come up flaps 1. We'll go to flaps 10. Actually, now we're over 100, so let's bring them all in. Fantastic. Around we go. There's Dead Man's Cove coming up. Dead Man's Bay. I'll do a touch and go there as well. All we've got to do is fly 160 mag, which is about here. Actually, probably need to adjust to come right slightly. We've got to go over this little bit of terrain into the bay ahead. Set cruise power or climb power. We'll fly this next bit manually. We need to come right actually around this terrain, I think. Probably do it going over the terrain actually, to be honest. Who have we got behind us? In the distance, chasing. We've got it trimmed up quite nicely here, actually. Vertical speed's just slightly shy of a positive number, though. Go around this bit of terrain. We could go over it, but we'll just go around it. And that's the lake that we want. Dead Man's Cove is over on that far side, in the trees again. T40, 75, and we are good. Akazato, you should have bought one with some floats. You're just doing loads of loops and things around us and orbits as we navigate the terrain below. Actually, we'll go over the water. We'll do a touch and go at Spruce Island's Brzezinski Airport instead, actually. As opposed to Dead Man's Cove, that's just a gravel strip. Zinki should be a little proper airport. Dead Man's Cove is coming up down there though. Should be. Is that it there? Don't think so. We're about to fly over it. You'll see it right at the last minute. Should be in the trees here. Just below the nose any second. To these airfields, you'd have to... in fact, is that it? I think that is. There we go. There's Dead Man Cove airstrip. So you've got to fly over the airfield, really. Judge what you can do arrival-wise, and then head in for an approach. But completely in the fields, in the trees there, a couple of bits at the end. But there's not much there for you to fly with, really. And then we're off over the water. Touch and go at Azinki, I think. 100 foot above sea level, that's saying. Runway 08, winds are calm. Wilfredo, hello to you, welcome aboard, thanks for subscribing to the channel. Over 14,000 subscribers now, guys, love it, thank you very much for choosing to subscribe, really appreciate every one of you. Don't forget to give today's live stream a little like as well if you are enjoying it, and check out our merch as well. What have we got? So there's a little blob of land. Trying to work out where Azinki is. I think it's just off the nose here, directly ahead, where that little bit of land cuts in with a lake behind it. I think that is Zinky just behind that. Might not even be that far, actually. We've got 1, 2, 3. Actually. Right, so this blob of land here, just the other side of that, behind the hill, should be Azinki, if I've read the maps right. And then we have one more airfield to do. We'll do a touch and go at Azinki and we'll head to Pak, which is Kodiak Island's municipal airport. Definitely aileron trim is a little bit out, isn't it? There's Ryan in the King Air, keeping up wonderfully. I think Bacazzato's crashed. I can't see him anymore. Crossing that Kodiak to Chignik Alaskan Marine Highway now, shipping lane. Well, apparently, Zinky's here somewhere. I can't quite see it yet, though. It's going to pop up any second again, isn't it, like the others have done so far. Let's hold 500-600 feet roughly for a minute. Back is Arto, no problem at all. That That bit of land juts round. The other side of that should be 08. He says. We'll do a touch and go. Come on, Zinky, where are you? Should be here. Anywhere here. It always pays to overfly the airfield, really, and then you can spot it. But that little jut of land that's just ahead of us here, the Zinky should be completely on the left, to the left of that bit of land. We'll do flaps 20, and we'll come in a bit quicker into a Zinky for this touch and go. There, green. Anywhere here, if it exists. Oh, there it is. Oh, well, let's go round and left. It's going to shout at us bank angle in a minute. We'll head back down. I did think it was strange we were climbing up away. Gives Nighthawk a chance to catch us up as well. So there's the little jut out in the land. There's a shed. There's my reference point. So we're kind of flying a downwind leg now. That pitch change, fantastic. I'm going to try and keep my altitude a little bit higher for this so I can actually spot it as we approach. Already lost it. Is that it? I think it could be. It's going well, isn't it?
Minimums.
Let's trim the trees for a second. Oh, there's the runway. Oh, we're doing a touch and go, so let's commit.
50, 40,
30, 20, 10. And just shy of the clouds. Oh, hello. Little power surge. Get around this bit of terrain. Quite distracting actually with the sort of runway lights positioned the way they were, a bit weird. Next stop, Kodiak Municipal. Which is over there somewhere. Back in our routing now. I think we can probably just sit at 1,000 feet, to be honest. Jolly good. Look at that. Sun's setting already. Don't get too many hours of sun at this time of year up here. We've got Fort Abercrombie Park here, and then we've got the Municipal Airport just beyond that coastline out of view here somewhere, I believe. In fact, where it juts in here, the airport's just obscured, so we use this little bit here as it juts in as a reference point for our approach, in fact. So we'll keep the props at 100. Eddie, hello to you. Welcome to Alaska. Kodiak Island, specifically. And our last landing of the day. And it's going to be on a proper runway here. I'm sure you'll all be pleased to know. Get gear down. Pull a Nighthawk in. Runway 21, this is going to be. I'm looking for it, and again, I'm not seeing. Oh, there it is. Idle the throttle a second, we'll get the flaps down properly. Here we go. Oh, look at this. Nice bit of freeware to end on. Get out of the way, van. 50, 40, 30, 20, 10. Oh, that was a heavy one. 408. Oh, dear. We'll just make use of the toe brakes, I think, for this one. We don't need reverse. Not quite sure where you park here. Back, so there we go. Round we go. There is a seaplane base as well, so you can land on this water strip if you wish. Some hangars here that we're going to park in. Here comes Bakasato in the DC-6. Brilliant. Mason, good afternoon to you. There we are. Park brakes. It's definitely another downhill airport, isn't it? God. a bit of WWE Smackdown there. I guess for a bit of freeware. Maxado's crashed. There's the seaplane base. You got a number of little Cessnas over there actually on the piers parked up. That's quite cool. And then you got the main Kodiak Airport off in the distance proper over there as well. Should have really landed this way, I think, over the lake. Would have made more sense, wouldn't it? What's going on with this light as well? Let's change. It's as bright as it's going to get. Here we go. And then we just got one more to land after this. Definitely an uneven airstrip this. That's my excuse for the 400 foot minute landing as well. Ed, should be in the description down below. If not, head into our Discord server, you'll find it in the live streams section for today. There is the PC6. And there's our final pilot of the day up here. Here he comes. He is very high. He's going for it. Look at that bank angle. What do we reckon? Butter. Sebastian, welcome on board. Thanks for subscribing. Welcome, welcome. There's the Latin VFR's ground vehicle pack as well. You see the Amazon lorry going past there. Oh, look at this. This is looking smooth. Looking very smooth. Look at that. Great little bit of freeware to end on. There we go, guys. So to those of you who joined us, I hope you've all enjoyed the route today flying along. Thanks to Jay Newbury for creating the route as well. Really good little trip around Alaska. All the scenery should be in the links in the description. If not, head to our Discord server, you'll find it all there. So you can download it all for free as well. Similarly, we've also used the Orbex Alaska Mesh add-on today to give it a little bit more of a boost as well. Welcome to all of our new subscribers. Thank you, Jay, as well, for dropping a kind, generous super chat earlier on prior to heading off. And thank you for creating the route today. I hope you've all enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. If you've not checked out the video that went live earlier today as well, then do check that out. Toolbar Pushback has now got this new pre-plan function, freeware add-on for MSFS. And in the video that went live this morning, it will show you basically how to use it and what it can do. So yeah, really good, worth checking out as well. A little video, about 12 minutes, two scenarios that I'll take you through there. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you potentially Tuesday for another live stream. Take care and enjoy the rest of the weekend.